attention. There is no learning without memory. And there is no learning without attention. It's like an equation. Memory plus attention equals learning.
Yes, it is.
In terms of neuroscience? Okay. So far, so good?
Yes.
Very nice. Let's move on. Neuromyth. I'm going to show you some pictures. And you tell me, what are the myths? So let's divide for question of, for the sake of time. Let's say, left and right. Where is the myth? Left or right? Who goes for the left? You go for the left. Where is the myth? Left or right? Left, right, true? Why?
Why? Because the brain is more complex and intertwined than just vitamins and supplements.
Good. What is the myth here? Left and right brain hemispheres. This is a big myth. There is no such thing as localization anymore. Why? Because neuroscience, when they didn't know that, back before 2000, and look what I'm talking about, we are 2017. How long a myth prevails? Back in 80s, they thought that it was localized. So that's the reason where or why this myth took root. But today we know, and why do we know? First, because there are lots of people. I'm going to show you a neuroscientist who works with lots of children who have been born with half of a brain. Her name is Mary Imurino Young. She does wonderful work researching and accompanying the development of these kids, who are, by all means, regular kids with half of a brain. How plastic can a brain be? So, this is a myth. This is the reality. We are made of neural pathways. We are made of connectivity. We are made of joint reactions. This is the interconnectedness. Have you ever heard of Norman Deutsch, a Canadian psychiatrist? He wrote two very, very famous books. Just for you to know, they are required reading everywhere. Harvard, Johns Hopkins, Stanford, UCLA, you name it. The Brain's Way of Healing, O Cérebro que Cura, already here available. Extremely good. And there is a documentary. It's available on YouTube. It's on my site too. I posted it there. Just for you to see, please watch. And marvel at the wonders of the brain. He says many circuits and even basic reflexes that we think are hardwired are not. Thinking, learning, acting can turn our genes on and off. Please pay attention to this. We are talking about the genome, and this is epigenetics. Part of our DNA gets rewritten every day. Shaping our brain anatomy and our behavior. Surely one of the most extraordinary discoveries of the 20th century, Norman Deutsch. Please watch the documentary. You love it. Do you want to know another neuromyth?
Sure.
This one is easy. Where is the myth? Okay, where is the myth? If I give you the next, you will kill it quickly. Reason and emotion. Emotion and cognition. Are they separate? Are they at the opposite of a pendulum or a balance? Of course not. Please, no. This is a beautiful study by Kassan and Kulit, just mapping out where in the brain the emotions resided for that person. when she was stimulated to feel happy or feel sad. The brain states and bodily responses are the fundamental facts of an emotion. So where do emotions lie? The heart is a beautiful thing, but it's a muscle. Once I was giving a workshop.
And it's not plastic.
When I said that learning was here, the guy, no, learning is here. I said, yes. Mm-hmm. This here pulses helps you to be alive, but brain is responsible for learning. Brain death. What happens to a person in brain death? Is declared dead. This is the importance of what you're talking about. I said, when you are in doubt, do the flipping mode. Think of what you will have if not. If I don't have a heart, oh, there are bypasses, stents, this and that, and everything else. If I don't have the brain. Joseph Ledoux, another essential reading. The Emotional Brain, already translated into Portuguese too. And Imordino Yang just published this book, Emotions, Learning, and the Brain. This is her, together with Antonio Damasio. Probably you've heard of him. Antonio Damasio is very famous for dealing with Descartes' Error, the title of one of his most famous books. We feel, therefore, we learn the relevance of affective and social neuroscience. That's a very promising field in neuroscience. Okay, another neuromyth? Ah, what is the myth? Some people are visual. Everybody is, I don't know what. And no, I am olfactory. I am gustatory. Oh my God, where would we be? Okay. You probably know this. Have you ever seen this?
Yeah.
Yes. What is this? This is Penfield homunculus. Who's Penfield? Who's homunculus? Homunculus is this little man. That's the meaning in Latin. Penfield was a Canadian neurosurgeon who, back in the 50s, performing lobotomies, he had to remove certain parts of the brain because of diseases people do have and do have to deal with that. But he noticed when he was performing the surgery that if he touched a certain common part in all the brains, that was the somatosensory cortex, that is right here, there would be instant reactions. The person would start laughing or touching or this or that. What is happening here? So he mapped out the sensory cortex, and he mapped it out according to how you see the projection of our parts of the body in this homunculus, how we feel. So we feel a lot in our mouth. We feel a lot in our feet, in our hand. Think about little children. What do they do with objects? Where was he? Thank you. Okay, so guys, up to now, there is no evidence whatsoever. And this, especially, is a great professor at cognitive psychology. He can find no evidence at all. So please, that's a myth not to be propagated. Okay. Now stop and reflect. We have seen what is the basis of this science. We have talked about the principles. We have examined three neuromyths. We are modest, we have little time. Now think. Brain functions and characteristics. Each brain unique. The context and environment. Each brain is different because of context and environment. Remember, context and ability. So there is a systematic variability, right? I'm not the same as you. You're not the same as him. So on and so forth. Even for Siamese brothers or sisters, there are differences. Twins, there are differences. So, if this transdisciplinary current body of knowledge allows us to understand that. And the differences are incremental, distributed, dynamic, rather than stable and categorical within an individual. We are always changing. A difficulty that I may have today may not be tomorrow. Guys, I had a terrible stutter. You know, stutter? For 15 years. Would you say that I'll be here one day talking about my brain education in English? Nobody. Can you believe if I had this dictated by me one day? So, I am a product of this. Please, this has been a collection of mine over the years. How many times have you heard people saying this? Many times, right? Many times. Can we abide by this knowingness? So please help me out. Please, we cannot let this happen. Today, ADHD is being considered a variety of bullying, not even a deficit anymore. Because it's transient, and we have to observe and respect that. I do have some minutes, right, mister?
One.
Okay. I'm going just to cite for a new action. I'm fine. We teachers have to have a transdisciplinary approach to the teaching learning process. This is a requisite. It's not a privilege anymore. Teaching is not like cooking. There is no recipe. Acknowledge the fact. We teachers have to think and learn continuously with the student in front of us, the whole human being. There is no one-size-fits-all approach. One derives from the other. Teachers need to work the part and the whole, the single and the group, the individual and everyone. Just like our brains do. We have parallel processing, simultaneous processing all the time. And acknowledge the fact that it's not always a sequential, nor order restrictive process. Because it is not. And we have to admit that to us. Okay, teachers need to differentiate and provide flexibilization for learner variability because we have those many brains in the classroom. So, today I sought out to explain what the science of MBEs checked. These well-established principles, checked. Neuromyths and why, checked. Reflection done, very deeply. Yes, very, very deep. Yes, I'll bet you'll learn and your brains will not be the same. Invite for a new action, are you with me? Thank you very much. Remember that this is the OECD document back in 2007, and some, just for you to bear in mind, posters. These were my references for this work. Then I'll let everything, it's already in my site. And it's my great privilege to announce a new baby sing. Best Tissot, yeah. Best Tissot is launching Mind, Brain, Education Sing. The launching event is September the 1st here in São Paulo at CNA headquarters. And the central committee is me as the head. North, please, Andressa, say hello. Yes. Northeast, Fernando Guarani didn't arrive. Poor thing, he's the secretary of Brexit. Okay. Central West, Andre.
The camera guy.
Southeast, Rodolfo, right there. This is the guy. And South, Daniela Silva, who could not be with us. Why? Because these people, they live in those regions. Brest Tissot is a country. Boy, we have to respect that. Regionalizing and making sure that these people are able to connect and liaison with the chapters, the other chapters, and the regional bodies will be better. And we will help other teachers in the